Peeraj, let me bring you in. As Karan was stating earlier, the fact that now companies are more open to, so, say, an open platform where they work with third-party providers, and it's a sort of a smart compartmentalization of data, where the company which is dealing directly with customers gets to see some data, and let's say they are using a third-party conversational messaging platform, that gets to see data without context in a way. Protecting the customer's data. So in a sense, tell us more about the capabilities that these conversational messaging platforms like Gupshup bring to the table, especially when looking at it from a third party provider, which integrates with, say, a company's already existing data.
No, I think, obviously we work with a wide variety of customers. Some are in regulated industries, some are not. Some have extremely tight security policies, while others maybe less so, right? So ultimately, platforms like ours, or at least we, offer a wide variety of solutions depending on what the preferences are, right? So one is at an infrastructure level, we've federated our whole platform architecture, which means, you know, we can really put the whole platform in different regions. So for example, in Europe for GDPR compliance, or in LATAM for, you know, their basically data localization in different countries, we can set up, replicate the whole platform. But to take it further, we can even set it up on-prem, right? Which means it could belong to just one company and nobody else even has access to it. So of course, it's still a platform, we maintain it, but on a day-to-day basis, you know, even we don't have access to it while they're using it, right? So that's sort of at the infrastructure layer. And then even in terms of the product and feature capability, in these messaging channels, we have mechanisms where you can have, for example, an expiring message, kind of like Snapchat, right? So you, or a single view message, meaning you can view the message and after 15 seconds, it disappears. So you see it once, but after that, there's no trail on your device. So if somebody finds your device later, they can't look at any of that data either, right? I mean, that's one example. Or it could be sort of a variation of the thing that Karan was talking about, which is, you know, you sort of pass encrypted tokens which refer to some data, but we don't have access to the data. Only the customer and the enterprise have that data. And I think this is such an important point, because today, for example, a lot of these messages go through SMS, and SMS is not, you know, I mean, ultimately, there's no way to encrypt content in the messaging payload, right? So that's where all these richer messaging channels that we provide have the ability to, you know, do various levels of security and privacy, so that only the user and or the enterprise has access to the data, and the platforms can work just fine, right? So these are the many different ways in which we handle these sort of requirements.
Absolutely. It's a platform that matters as well, especially considering the capabilities that it brings to the table.